You've worked really hard to save your money and now you're ready to spend it. But before you buy your new sneakers, game or headphones, you have to answer one question. Can I afford it? The answer will depend on the item's price. Prices are just a way of giving goods and services a value. But here's the thing, prices don't stay the same. They change depending on things like how much the item costs to make, how many people want to buy it or how badly they want it, how much people can afford to pay, and how many businesses can make the item. Your money has a value too. That's the amount of goods and services you can buy with it. And that depends a lot on prices. Prices tend to rise over time. When prices of many things we buy are rising, this is called inflation. In the last video, we explored our economy and the sectors within it. Inflation can have a big effect on them. A little bit of inflation is good. When inflation is low and stable, it is easier for households and businesses to plan what they will buy and make decisions. And overall, this helps our economy to grow. But if prices rise too quickly and people's wages don't keep up, your money doesn't buy as much as it used to. We say it's lost some of its value. That's bad news for you and the economy. Here's an example. Imagine that you've saved for weeks for a pair of sneakers that cost $50. Finally, you've got enough. But when you get to the shop, the price has risen to $55. Maybe this happened because the price of the raw materials that go into the sneakers went up. Or maybe it was because lots of other people wanted the sneakers too. Or in other words, demand to buy the sneakers was strong. So businesses selling them raised prices. In any case, it may make you think twice about buying them or choosing not to. Now imagine that the prices of lots of goods and services are rising, not just sneakers. Groceries are more expensive, clothes are more expensive, cars are more expensive. You can buy less and less with your money. So how can inflation be controlled so that our money doesn't lose its value and people can still afford to buy the things they need and want? That's where the Reserve Bank of Australia comes in. The Reserve Bank, or RBA, is Australia's central bank. It's very different to other banks, which are really businesses that hold your savings or lend you money. The RBA has an important role to play in keeping inflation low and steady. This helps a range of other things, like the growth of our economy and the number of jobs available. Economists at the RBA look at what's happening in the economy, here and overseas. They analyse things like how quickly prices are rising, how many people have a job, and how much people are spending. This helps them determine how well the economy is running and how they should act to make sure inflation remains low and steady. To do this, the RBA board makes a decision about what should happen with interest rates, whether they should move up, down, or stay the same. But how can changing interest rates affect prices and inflation? By setting a special interest rate in the economy, called the cash rate, the RBA can influence the interest rates banks offer to the people and businesses that want to save or borrow with them. In the last video, we saw how higher interest rates encourage people to save because they get more money back on their savings and borrowing is more expensive. But lower interest rates make it cheaper to borrow money and people earn less on their savings. So by changing interest rates, the RBA can influence how much money households and businesses choose to save, borrow and spend. And because what people spend affects prices, the RBA can use interest rates to affect how quickly prices rise, and so control inflation. Raising interest rates reduces spending and slows down inflation. Lowering interest rates encourages spending and can speed up inflation. Overall, when inflation is low and steady, our money keeps its value. And it's easier for households and businesses to make decisions without needing to worry about big or surprising movements in prices. And that's good for us and the economy.